Hello guys, I am Andrea from Cuore di Cioccolato. Today we make camembert cheese at home. Very easy. You need 5 liters of milk. In the pot I put already 3 tablespoons of yogurt, plain yogurt, the white one, the normal one without sugar, without anything inside. Why we need the yogurt? Because in the yogurt there is the ferment. We need to add this ferment to our cheese. Plus 150 milliliters of cream, normal cream, plain cream again, to give more fat to our cheese. If you have, you can use the whey from the cheese that you have made last time that you make the cheese. So yesterday I made the Italico cheese. I keep my whey. You can use it for pizza, for bread instead of the water, or you can use for the next time that you will make cheese again. It's very important because it helps the milk to become a cheese. So after that you prepare the cheese, you have the whey, you can store in the refrigerator. You frozen it one day before that you decide to make the cheese, you defrozen it and you can use it. We need the rennet. I will use 3 milliliter of rennet. In Italy we can find the pharmacy. In many countries you need to order online. So I will put the link under the video to order it on Amazon in the States or here in Italy. Up to you. If you need to find some other country, you can tap rennet. Well, I can buy it in my country. Very easy. 3 milliliter. And naturally we need also the malt. Some people will say, if I should buy the malt, what's the point? But if you want to do this kind of cheese, that white is white outside, you need the malt. So the option are two: or you buy the malt, you mix with the milk and put everything inside, or you buy a small piece of cheese and you can collect the malt directly from the cheese. I done like this. I will take the mold from this cheese. Now we add all the ingredients inside. Not the rennet. The rennet we need to add later. After we put the pot on the stove, we reach the temperature of 37 Celsius degree. After we add the rennet, we can go ahead with our cheese. Reach 37 Celsius degree, we turn off the fire, we add the rennet, we mix with energy at least 1-2 minutes. After we stop the milk should not move anymore. We cover with the lid and we wait 60 minutes. After 1 hour, you take a long knife and you cut the curd in big pieces, different direction. And after we should wait at least 10 minutes. During this time, I can explain you what I've done here. Because we need a long basket, but small dimension, it's very difficult to find it. So I make it. You take the bottle of the milk, now I show you. You cut the extremity, please be careful, don't cut yourself. And after, we can put here is on this sushi mat that I already show you when I do the homemade pasta garganelli. So in this occasion you can use it again. I don't know if you make the sushi at all, but for sure you bought it and never use it. So now you can use it again. See you in 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, you can notice that the curd is divided from the whey. Now with a big spoon or a soup spoon, I don't know if it's the right name, you take your curd and you put in your container. One spoon here, one here, one here, and you go like this until you finish all your curd. Because a lot of whey will go down the container, try to organize yourself like you are more comfortable. I'm doing like this to do the video, but maybe here is not the right place. If you do here, it's better. Plus, remember to collect the whey, because you can use instead of the water when you prepare your bread or your pizza dough, will be perfect. You can use for the ricotta, to make the ricotta, or you can use it next time that you will make the cheese. After that we put all the curd inside the basket, we should wait 12 hours. Remember that from here, the cheese will be after only like this. You need time. So see you tonight in 12 hours. After 12 hours, you can notice the differences. The dimensions are very different from the beginning. Now we should turn upside down our cheese. When you touch them, please be careful because they are very soft. We should keep like this for 48 hours, 2 days. But every 12 hours you need to turn upside down. So please be careful when you move them. I will not show you every time that I turn upside down. So see you in a few days. After 48 hours, we can remove the cheese from our container. One thing only, when you decide to use the bottle like me, please find a bottle without this mark. If not, it will be too difficult to turn upside down your cheese when it's here inside and some piece will be broken. So we say after 48 hours, we need to salt our cheese. So you take a pinch of salt on the top, pinch of salt on the bottom and pinch of salt all around. Please don't exaggerate. After I will put my cheese again on this sushi mat and in a plastic container and in the fridge. When the mold start growing, I will update you. You need to turn upside down the cheese every day. After only 4 days in the fridge, the white mold have covered already all our cheese. If you have saw some green mold, don't worry, it's normal. It's because the camembert that I found it was mixed with a blue cheese. So in my cheese there will be both mold, the white and the blue from the blue cheese. But don't worry, nothing wrong is happening. Now I will turn upside down my cheese. I will put again in the fridge. See you. After 8 days, you can see that the mold already covered completely our cheese. And when you touch it, you already can notice the differences. Inside start to be a little bit soft. So I will wait 1 week more. I think I cannot resist more. And I will cut one to see inside what is going on. Now I turn upside down all of them and put again in the fridge. Remember to turn upside down your cheese every day. Spettacular. After 4 weeks is perfect, very spectacular. You can wait until maximum 6 weeks, so you have 2 weeks more to eat the other three small cheese. Now I will taste it with my homemade apple cider or apple wine. Papam, like champagne or prosecco. Okay guys, it's super spectacular, especially here in the nature. If you are not subscribed yet, please remember to subscribe to the channel, to leave me a like, to watch and share this video with your friends. If you make this kind of cheese, if you make other cheese, please let us know down in the comment. If you want share some recipe with me about cheese or about other recipe, you can write me down here in the comment, or you can write me on Instagram. In Instagram is more easy, it's more private, easy to save the recipe. One thing more, the sushi mat is completely white like the cheese. So the next bunch of cheese that you will make, if you will put on this mat, the mold will work faster and even better. Bye bye.